In this video, we are going to discuss one of the very important collections, that is our Scala sets. Now, what is a Scala set? Scala set is a collection of different elements of the same type. That means all the elements must be different, but their type, the data type, will be same. So, in other words, a set is a collection of that contains no duplicate elements. There are two kinds of sets are possible. One is the immutable set, another one is the mutable set. The difference between mutable and immutable objects is that when an object is immutable, the object itself cannot be changed. And that is a basic property of immutable object. By default, Scala uses the immutable set. If you define one set object, by default, it is immutable set. That means the respective values cannot be changed. If you want to use the mutable set, then you have to import explicitly. We are supposed to import, that is scala.collection.mutable.set class. So this is a class and this is a respective package. So import scala.collection.mutable.set class explicitly. If you want to use both mutable and immutable sets in the same collection, then you can continue to refer to the immutable set as set, but you can refer to the mutable set as mutable.set in this way. So here is one sample code to have the better idea. So here is how you can declare immutable sets. So that is the way to declare it. So just see var s colon set int is equal to set. So empty set of integer type. So here you see when you are defining one in empty set, then this data type, mentioning this data type is mandatory. So in other words, if you want to define one integer set, then how to define that one? Var s colon set int is equal to set. You are putting the values because it is not the empty set. You are having some values there. Let it be 1, 3, 5, 7. Otherwise, you can also define in this way. Var s is equal to set 1, 3, 5, 7 separated by commas. Here you see, here we need not to mention that is colon set int because here we are not going to define any empty set. So while defining an empty set, the type annotation is necessary as the system needs to assign a concrete type to a variable. So from here we are getting the data type, so that is the integer. So that's why here this particular type annotation is optional. So in this particular discussion, we have defined what is a set, what is immutable and mutable sets, and how to define them, how to declare them as well. Thanks for watching this video.